I was a longtime fan of Martin. All my heroes played them. I always saw this little script up here, and I always wondered what that said. And I got a job in a music store that was a Martin dealer, and I found out. Bought my first D-28 there. I think it was back in 1970. And I was so proud of it. I had the guitar that all my heroes played. So, and then I bought a D-35. That's the one with a three-piece back. And then I bought a D-12-28. And then I bought myself a D-45 in New York City. And I remember riding back from New York City on the train with the case next to me with the lid open and staring at it. Couldn't believe that I had it. But longtime Martin lover. And I own several of them. I spent 12 years of my life trying to get a job with the company. And they let me in one day. I started off as a neck shaper. And then moved on into the repair department and R&D work I did. I was a tour guide. Became a production. I had to do special things to guitars, in production. People would request certain things, a certain playability, and I did all that. And so I worked in another guitar company before that in Connecticut, Ovation Guitars. I worked for them for 15 years, so I'm a guitar lover, a guitar player. I wanted to work in guitar factories because that way I could be close to them. So anyway, and so that's a little bit about me. I'm from the state of Connecticut, living up in Franklin, Tennessee. And last year, I won the state flat top guitar contest up there in Clarksville, Tennessee. There were 16 other good guitar players, and I took number one. I was really surprised. Oh, thank you. And I played a tune that I wrote. I was the only one that played an original tune, and I was the only one that played it unaccompanied. And I played this tune that I made up called the Arthel Lane Ramble. Anybody know who Arthel Lane was? Does that sound familiar? How about Doc Watson? Does that sound familiar? That was his birth name. And somebody gave him the nickname Doc, and it kind of stuck with him. So I called this tune that I'm going to play the Arthel Lane Ramble. That was my guitar. It's a wonderful guitar. This has also forward shifted scallop top braces on it. Really, as you heard, it sounds great. Well, what happens is when the X brace crosses right here, And when you move the X forward, the span of the lower X spreads out or widens under the bridge, makes the top a little more flexible, gives it a bigger bass response. When you move it back, it tightens up underneath the bridge area, and treble comes out a little bit more. And then there's non-scallop braces, like a D28, and those guitars have a really nice balance between treble, mid-range, and bass. The bass isn't overpowering. The treble is good and strong. I see it as more of a guitar you would finger pick, or you would play lead guitar, kind of flat picking stuff like I just did. All right, well, I'm going to play a pretty waltz here that I learned recently. It's called the Gypsy Waltz. This is a tune called Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain.
In the twilight, glow I see her. Blue eyes crying in the rain. Goodbye and parted, I knew we'd never meet again. Love is like a burning ember. He's out of time. And only memories remain. Through the ages, I'll remember. Blue eyes crying in the rain. Through I'll remember. Blue eyes crying in the rain. Blue eyes crying in the rain.